Hi students, welcome to English class. How are you all? Are you preparing well for the forthcoming exams? Yes, very good. Do you feel bored sitting within the four walls of your house, not allowed to go anywhere in these pandemic days? Don't worry, let's go for a tour. Now, those who love traveling, do raise your hands. Oh, all of you. Then shall we go to an island? Tell me, what is an island? Yes, it's a piece of land surrounded by water. Here is an image of an island. Today, we are going to explore an island named Kandau in Fiji. Are you all ready with the text? Okay, let's see what the lesson is about. Children, what is the title of the lesson? Yes, The Sacred Turtles of Kandau. Kandau Dhyubile, Vishuddharaya Kadalamagal. Now turn the page and see who is the author. Is there any author's name? No? Now read what is written at the end of the lesson. From a Fijian legend. Legend is a traditional story passed from one generation to the other. So, what we are going to learn today? Correct! A traditional story from Fiji that is passed from generation to the other about the sacred turtles of Kandau. Have you seen a turtle? Look at the image of a turtle. Isn't it so big? Okay, shall we read the first paragraph of the lesson? Here it is. On the island of Kandau, one of the larger islands of the Fiji group and some 50 miles by water from the capital city of Suva, is the Fijian village of Namwana. Namwana nestles at the foot of a beautiful bay adjacent to the government station in Vunisi Harbour. Here, the island of Kandau narrows down to an isthmus, and by climbing the hill behind Namwana village, one can stand on the saddle and look out to the sea to the south and to the north. Legend says that in the days gone by, the warriors of Kandau slid their canoes on rollers up over the narrow neck of land to save the long journey around the east and the west of Kandau Island. Children, tell me, what is the paragraph about? Very good. It is the description of the Kandau Island. Did you say Kadavu? It is pronounced Kandau. Yes, that's correct. But no problem, because there are regional varieties in the pronunciation of any language. Now, let's come back to the text. Kandau is an island of the Fiji group. Do you know that there are around 320 islands in Fiji and only 100 are inhabited? On the Kandau Island, there is a beautiful village. What is its name? Very good. Namwana. Where is Namwana village situated? Yes, Namwana village is situated at the foot of a beautiful bay. Do you know what a bay is? Bay means ulkadal. Here is the image of a bay. And it is next to the government station in Vunisi Harbour. We can reach the village if we travel some 50 miles by sea from the capital city of Fiji called Suva. Fiji Dyubu Samuhatil Petta, Uru Valiya Dyubana, Kandau. ഫിജിയൻ തലസ്ഥാന നഗരിയായ സുവയിൽ നിന്നും 50 മൈൽ കടലിൽ കൂടി യാത്ര ചെയ്താൽ അതിമനോഹരമായ നമ്മോന ഗ്രാമത്തിൽ എത്തിച്ചേരാം. നമ്മോന ഗ്രാമം സ്ഥിതി ചെയ്യുന്നത് ഉൾക്കടലിനോട് ചേർന്നാണ്. തൊട്ടപ്പുറത്തുള്ളത് മ്യൂണിസി തുറമുഖത്തുള്ള ഒരു ഗവൺമെന്റ് സ്റ്റേഷനാണ്. ഹിയർ ദ ഐലൻഡ് ഓഫ് കണ്ടാവു എപ്പിയേഴ്സ് ആസ് ആൻ ഇസ്മസ്. ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ഡു യു നോ വട്ട് ആൻ ഇസ്മസ് ഇസ്? ലുക്ക്, ഹിയർ ഇസ് is the image of an isthmus. Now, let's look at the meaning of an isthmus. An isthmus is a narrow strip of land with sea on either side connecting to larger areas of land. If you climb the hill behind Namwana village, you can stand on the saddle and enjoy the sea northwards and southwards. Saddle means leather seat attached on a horseback. കണ്ടാവ് ദ്വീപ് ഇവിടെ ഒരു കര ഇടുക്കായിട്ടാണ് കാണപ്പെടുന്നത്. നമ്മോന ഗ്രാമത്തിൻ്റെ പിറകിലുള്ള കുന്നിൻപുറം കയറിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്ക് കടലിൻ്റെ തെക്ക് ഭാഗവും വടക്ക് ഭാഗവുമുള്ള കാഴ്ചകൾ ആസ്വദിക്കാൻ പറ്റും. നൗ ടെൽ മീ, വട്ട് ഇസ് ദ ലെജൻഡ് സേ? യെസ്, അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ദ ലെജൻഡ്, ദ വാരിയേഴ്സ് ഓർ ദ സോൾജേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് കണ്ടാവു യൂസ് ടു റോൾ ദിയർ കനൂസ് അലോങ് ദ ഇസ്മസ് to avoid long journey around east and west of Kandau Island. ഐതിഹ്യം പറയുന്നത് കണ്ടാവ് ദ്വീപിലുള്ള യോദ്ധാക്കൾ പണ്ടുകാലത്ത് ദ്വീപിൻ്റെ കിഴക്കും പടിഞ്ഞാറും ചുറ്റി സഞ്ചരിക്കാനുള്ള ബുദ്ധിമുട്ട് കാരണം ഈ കരയിടുക്കിലൂടെ കെട്ടുവള്ളങ്ങളെ ഉരുട്ടിത്തള്ളി മറുകരയിലേക്ക് പോകുന്ന രീതി ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു എന്നതാണ്. ചിൽഡ്രൻ, നൗ കൻ യു ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് ടു ടേംസ് യു ഹാവ് കം അക്രോസ് ഇൻ ദിസ് പാസേജ് related to island? Yes, you are right. Bay and isthmus. You are familiar with the terms boat and ship. Have you heard of the term canoe? Let's see the image of a canoe. So what is a canoe? Canoe means a light narrow boat with pointed end propelled with a paddle. Now let's read the second paragraph. All of you listen carefully. The women of Namwana village still preserve a very strange ritual, that of turtle calling from the sea. If you visit Namwana village to see the turtle calling, your schooner anchors in a beautiful bay right under the cliffs of a rocky headland. You land on the beach and then either sit on the rocks under the bluffs on the beach or climb a rocky tract to a point some 150 or 200 feet up the rock face. Here you have a splendid view and will find assembled all the maidens of the village of Namwana singing a strange chant. As they chant, if you look very carefully down into the water of the bay, you will see giant turtles rise one by one to lie on the surface listening to the music. This is not a fairy tale. It actually does take place, and the water in this area is forbidden for the fishing of turtles. The women of Namwana village perform a very strange ritual. What is the name of the ritual? Right, turtle calling. നിങ്ങൾ നമ്മോന ഗ്രാമം സന്ദർശിക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങളുടെ പായക്കപ്പൽ പാറക്കെട്ടുകൾ നിറഞ്ഞ ഒരു സ്ഥലത്തായിരിക്കും നങ്കൂരമിടുക. Now tell me, what is the English term for നങ്കൂരമിടുക? Yes, anchor. Okay, let us find out how the ritual is performed. The view of the ritual is splendid or very impressive. All the maidens or the unmarried women of the Namwana village will assemble on the shore and they will sing a strange chant. Chant ennu paranjal geetham. What happens next will surprise you. From the deep waters of the sea, giant turtles will rise to the surface of the water one by one and they will be listening to the music. Aren't you surprised? Oh, I can imagine the surprise on your faces. It's not a fairy tale. ഭീമൻ കടലാമകൾ കന്യകമാരുടെ ഗീതം കേട്ട് കടലിൽ നിന്നും ഉയർന്നു വരുന്നതൊരു കെട്ടുകഥയല്ല. ദിസ് ഈസ് എ ട്രൂ ഇൻസിഡൻറ്റ്. ഓക്കെ, നൗ ക്യാൻ യു ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് ദ ടേംസ് യൂസ് ടു ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ് ദ ഫിസിക്കൽ ഫീച്ചേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് നമോന വില്ലേജ് ഫ്രം ദിസ് പാരഗ്രാഫ്? യെസ്, വെരി ഗുഡ്. ക്ലിഫ്സ്, റോക്കി ഹെഡ്ലാൻഡ് ആൻഡ് ബ്ലഫ്. ലെറ്റ് അസ് ഹാവ് എ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദ ക്ലിഫ്. Cliffs means steep rock. Rocky headland ennu vachal paarakettu. Here is the image of bluff. Bluff means a rounded cliff that projects to a body of water. Now let me ask you a question. In the previous paragraph we have come across the term canoe, which means a boat. Can you find out similar noun used for sailing in sea in this paragraph? Excellent! Schooners. Schooners ennu paranjal iratta paya kappal. Here is the image of a schooner. Well, it's time for an assignment. See the screen. Suppose you are a reporter of a TV channel and you are assigned the task of reporting live on TV, how will you report the turtle calling? Prepare the script for live TV report on turtle calling. Shall we watch a live TV report by one of your friends? Watch carefully how she reports.
Morning ladies and gentlemen, it's me Diya Partha from ABC channel reporting the strange ritual practiced by the women of Namoana village. The village is all on the shore. The sun is blazing and the shore is all crowded with holidaymakers and tourists. They are all eagerly waiting to see the turtle calling. Now, I can see a group of ladies all in traditional costumes. They are holding a club and are heading to the shore. They are chanting a strange song. The ritual has an interesting legend. Are you excited to know more about the legend? Wait, let me ask one of the local men about it. Now I can see the turtles rising to the shore and lying on the sandy beaches. Here, have a closer look at it. Now it's time for me to wind up the show. It's me Diya Partha signing off with cameraman Varun. Thank you.
Yes, have you noticed the features of the live TV report? How did the student begin? Yes, she began with a salutation, ladies and gentlemen. Then she introduced herself and the channel. After that, moved on to reporting. Have you noticed the tense form she followed while reporting? Very good. Present tense. So, remember to use present tense while reporting. At last, you can end the TV report with a thank you. Complete the assignment and don't forget to send it to your English teacher. Now let's read the last line of the paragraph once more. This is not a fairy tale. It actually does take place and the water in this area is forbidden for the fishing of turtles. This area is forbidden or not allowed for the fishing of turtles. Now how will you write it as a warning notice by beginning with do not? Yes, I know that some of you are answering. Good. Look at the screen. Do not fish turtles here. Can you think of two more sentences beginning with do not that we should follow on such areas of rituals? Think about it and write the answers. Send it to your English teacher, okay? Shall we move on to the third paragraph? Good. Another interesting sideline to this performance is that if any member of the nearby village of Nabukelavu is present, then the turtles will not rise to the surface of the bay and the turtle calling will have to be abandoned. What do you think of the ritual after the reading? Don't you think the ritual is strange? Now tell me, what makes it strange? Yes, you are right. If any member of the neighboring village, Nabukelavu, is present during the ritual, then the turtles won't rise to the bay. And hence, the turtle calling has to be abandoned. What do you mean by abandoned? Yes, ubekshikuga. ഈ ആചാരത്തിന് ഒരു വശം കൂടിയുണ്ട്. അയൽ ഗ്രാമമായ നബുക്കെളുവിലെ ഏതെങ്കിലും പ്രജയുടെ സാന്നിധ്യം ആചാര സമയത്ത് അനുഭവപ്പെട്ടാൽ കടലാമകൾ കടലിൻ്റെ മുകളിലേക്ക് ഉയർന്നു വരികയില്ല. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ആമകളെ ക്ഷണിക്കുന്ന ഈ ചടങ്ങ് ഉപേക്ഷിക്കേണ്ടതായി വരും. ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ക്യാൻ യു ഗെസ് ദ റീസൺ ബിഹൈൻഡ് ദ അബാൻഡൺമെൻ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി റിച്വൽ? ഈസ് ഇറ്റ് ബിക്കോസ് സംതിങ് ഈവിൾ ഹാസ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് അറ്റ് ദ ഹാൻഡ്സ് ഓഫ് ദി villagers of Nabukelavu? We don't know yet. Now, let's refresh what we have learned so far. Shall we try the role of a tourist guide of Kandau Island and walk along with the few tourists around the island? Okay, have a look at the screen. Imagine yourself to be a travel guide of Kandau Island. A group of tourists visit the island to attend the ritual turtle calling. How would you welcome them? Let's find out how to write the welcome speech. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the exotic island of Kandau. I am your tourist guide, Mr. John, and I am here to guide you throughout the tour. I heartily welcome you all to enjoy the splendid view of the island. Also, many surprises await you in the island. Come on, let's start our trip. Have you noticed how the speech began? Yes, correct, with the salutation, ladies and gentlemen. Then the tourist guide introduced himself and then move on to welcome the tourist. Let's read the second paragraph of the speech. Dear tourist, I shall tell you something about the location of the island. Kandau is one of the largest islands in Fiji. This island has a beautiful village called Namwana. We can reach this village in Kandau by traveling some 50 miles by sea from the capital city of Suva. The island is a rocky land full of cliffs, rocky headland and bluffs. What do you think the guide describes in the second paragraph? Yes, the island's location and its landscape. So, in the second paragraph, description of the island should be written. Let's see what to be written in the third paragraph. Here is the shore where the strange ritual turtle calling is performed. I shall introduce this special event to you all. Please listen. All the maidens of the Namwana village assemble on the shore and sing a strange chant. On hearing the chant, giant turtles would rise from the deep sea to the surface of the blue waters. Now tell me, what did you understand after reading the third paragraph? Yes, the special event of the place is introduced. So, here you have to describe the special events or highlights of the place. Now have a look at the fourth paragraph. Dear tourist, we must follow some rules in this area. The most important one is, do not fish turtles in the area. Also, you have to be very careful while walking along the island. Here, coastlines are full of slippery rocks and the cliffs are too steep. You may slip and may get hurt. So, be careful. Also, the waves are dangerous. What did you understand from reading of this paragraph? Yes, you are right. The tourist guide is warning the tourist about the rules to be followed in certain areas, and also he gives pieces of advice to the tourist. So you have to include these points in this paragraph. Finally, the closing remarks. You can end the speech by thanking them for visiting the island. Let's come back to the lesson. We stopped where ritual has to be abandoned at the presence of the villagers of Nabukelavu. Aren't you curious to know the reason? Yes? Let's find out the reason in the next class. By then, do complete your assignments and send it to your English teacher. Let me wind up the session with a quotation from Saint Augustine. The world is a book, and those who do not travel reads only a page. See you soon. Thank you.